mogul's idea to change the names of neighborhoods to make them fancier and get more money for the parking that they create. Also down the road. Major thoroughfares like 14th Street, 23rd Street, 2nd Street, those are two-way. Park Avenue is the only avenue that's two-way. And it's poor traffic and resilience. Most even-numbered streets run east, in case you ever get lost. So keep that in mind. Anyway, Broadway crosses Houston and separates East Houston from West Houston. Broadway is still a really good place to shop. A lot of major chain stores and small shops went off. Broadway was busier. Obviously, no one was so much busier pre-pandemic. A lot of stuff happened to us then. Yeah, the building to our left, that's burning, you know. Oh, you should have seen the other day, was it a couple of weeks ago, when the whole city was orange, the sky couldn't breathe. Did you have it in Connecticut, that terrible?
Did you have to cancel the bus tours during that time?
I didn't happen to work that day.
Oh,
so
okay.
Probably, would you think? Okay. Anyway, there's a statue in the plaza behind this modern building to our right. Can't see it from here, but if you're ever walking around LaGuardia Place in Greenwich Village, it's a Picasso sculpture, an outdoor car Picasso sculpture called La Tetris Silvette. So we're going into Greenwich Village next. Greenwich Village does not follow the grid, the rectilinear grid of streets and avenues, because it was already developed in 1811 when the grid system was created. So Greenwich Village in front of us is a windy, meandering streets, mostly with names of the people who live there, not numbers. It's a great place to go. It's very European in feel. Beautiful old buildings, restaurants, bars, music. Greenwich Village was the home to Bohemia in the 40s and 30s, 40s and 50s. Greenwich Village starts at 6th Avenue, goes all the way to the water. We're going to be on the very eastern edge here. Our Greenwich Village. Minetta Street, which crosses Minetta Road, which crosses Minetta Brook, on which is the Minetta Tavern. Anyway, very strange. The Minetta Theater. So he married this young, and he found out later that she had had an affair before the marriage with this guy named Stanford White. So he went where Stanford White was, at a restaurant in Madison Square Garden number 2, which Stanford White actually built. He was an architect. And Harry shot Stanford in the head. And so he was tried in Jefferson Park and put out as a crazy guy. And he was, in fact, that. The building itself is beautiful if you're in the area walking around. So, this is still Greenwich Village, though it doesn't feel like it. But they sort of say Greenwich Village, I see, this is usually a busy apartment. Thank you. largest park that's built on a railroad trestle. Now, think about this. The road we're on is called Sixth Avenue. And this is Ladies Mile. You're going to see some beautiful buildings built in the Gilded Age, 1890 to 1980. And they were built for warehousing goods and merchandising goods in retail department stores. As I said, like Macy's and Saks and Lord Taylor. The second story windows are very big because the people on the subway another triangular square, which we only call a square. It's actually two triangles. One is called Greeley Square, named for Horace Greeley, the publishing guy who said, "Go West, young man." And the other is Herald Square, named for the New York Herald, which was a newspaper. Thank you. started out on 14th Street and 6th Avenue. It moved up to Ladies Mile, 18th Street and 6th Avenue. And then in 1892, it moved to Herald Square. It is 2.2 million square feet of retail space on 11 floors. It's huge. Even if you don't want to go inside, walk around, get lost. It's really wonderful that there is still a brick and mortar store like it. It was founded by a guy by the name of, guess, Macy. Yeah. Roland Hussey Macy. He was a sailor from New England. He moved down to New York and built a dry goods store. Did well, moved up. And because he was a sailor, he had a lot of tattoos, and one of them was a big red star. And so if you know Macy's logo, it's a big red or white star, and that's from his tattoo. Another famous story about Macy's has just come to light again. Not only the regular story I always tell on the bus, but you know, up in at the Titanic site, there was just a horrible incident where the submersible tried to successfully sightsee around the Titanic, and unfortunately it imploded. Well, here's this strange story. You know the movie Titanic? Is a little old Jewish couple. They'd been married forever. They knew that the ship was going down. He wasn't going to get on a lifeboat. She said, I'm gonna stay with you, honey. That was Isidore and Ida Strauss. They were part owners of Macy's. And they died aboard the Titanic. The captain of the submersible was married to the great-granddaughter of the Strauss. Isn't that something? Rush, Stockton Rush, married to the great-granddaughter of the Titanic, you know what I mean? Oh my God, that's good. Anyway, there is a Titanic entrance to Macy's. There's a plaque commemorating the Strausses. And they found his body. He's actually buried in the Bronx. Mrs. Strauss was never found. She gave her maid her mink coat, and the maid survived. The maid actually lived until about 1949, and she stayed warm on the boat. And his valet was never found. I don't know what happened. Now, this tragic happens on occasion, so we're going to get through it as quickly. Can you imagine, back in the day, all the streets and avenues were two-way? So they created this one-way concept to speed traffic through. Can you picture this? Anyway, so the rainbow flare on the kind of a little brighter, makes the fogs go away. So we're going to see Macy's up ahead. It'll be on the left side of the road. Gimbel's was just next door to it. Back in the, you know, you saw the Miracle on 34th. Gimbel's and Macy's. Now you're going to see on some street lamps, circular plaques. They're either the crests or the flags of South and Central American countries. This street is also known as 6th Avenue as Avenue of the Americas. It was created, that name was given to it in the 40s by the same mayor who named Patience and Fortitude in Water. Anyway, so this is Avenue of the Americas. He was very involved in Pan-American community and thus living in the also at 34th Street and 6th Avenue, the 6th Avenue and Broadway toward 34th Street, thusly we get on train, is that big tall building, which was a hotel, it's now apartments. And on the second floor is a brand new exhibit called the Harry Potter Experience. I have no interest myself in going, but you may want to. $30 for that. So that's our goal. So we're going to go also traveling to see the two triangles created by the confluence of avenues crossing each other. Slowing our progress. I guess I should introduce myself. That's fine. So my name is Elaine. That's how we say it. Some people say Elaine. But I say Elaine because I've been called Eileen too many times. So my name is Elaine. I've been doing this for longer than some of you have been alive. It is my greatest pleasure. I have the best job in the world when I decide to work. Our driver's name is Greg. Yay, Greg. He's got the worst job in the world. Anybody can do this all day. But together we have a good job, right? And what we would love for you to do is when we get to the end of our time together, I have these little cards that I give out, and he has some as well. So if you feel that you had a good time and it was an enjoyable experience, the company likes to hear from you by way of Google Maps and TripAdvisor. So there's QR codes on the cards, and we appreciate 5-star reviews like you wouldn't believe. But, you know, whatever you can do, we appreciate. So that's just my, that's my advice. Up ahead on the right, we see Greeley Square, which is the first triangle. Horace Greeley was the publisher of the Tribune, which merged with the Herald, and the Herald became the Herald Tribune. Yeah, left to see it. You can't really see it. Madison Square.
Oh, okay. Penn Station.
Getting robbed. Oh, it was so exciting. I said, take out your cameras very calmly. That was great. All right, what are you honking? By the way, it is illegal to honk in New York City. Oh, yeah. Oh, God, if I was the honking police, I would be loaded. You can only honk for a purpose, not because you're in a hurry. Okay, keep it down. What are we supposed to do? Oh, let's see. Anything going on in front? Did we miss all of that? Everybody's standing. dressing for holidays. They still have great windows at Christmas, and they hire Santa Claus.
They're offering Zach
McNabb, who has a great window. Institute on 47th Street. I went there once to get my engagement necklace. We didn't have money for a ring, so I... In any event, we're going to get 47th Street, and it has two Tiffany diamond settings as street lamps. It's fabulous. So if you're camera people, you look to the right at 47th Street. Wonderful rest of your visit. My pleasure has been with you. Take your earbuds, it's our gift to you. You can plug in your phone in it. Wait until I give you the high sign before you stand up. And thank you. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you.